So I guess you could see the Igor CD in my Radiohead article video, which a lot of you watched, I mean a lot of you, and I'm so thankful for that. But that does beg the question, why does a mostly metal and alternative music listener listen to Tyler, the Creator? Because I love him. You probably don't know me for being much of a hip-hop fan, because I'm not. But you know, I have crossed my paths with rap music before, and I like many hip-hop artists now, but still Tyler has been my favorite ever since I was introduced to him by New Magic Wand and Earthquake. One of my friends, who's even more music addicted than me, made me listen to the entirety of Igor last November, and I instantly fell in love with it. I was basically like, so naturally I decided to listen to every single one of his projects, as I usually do, and rank them, so let's go.
Monkey.
At spot 7, I put Goblin. Now, this really should be no surprise, considering that the lyrics, the mixing, the beats, I mean, they're not the best. The lyrics are purely shock value, like they don't really have much meaning, they're just purely there to like piss off white Americans, basically. And the mixing and the beats sound really, really outdated. Even my favorite song from the album, Yonkers, is not that big of an achievement. I heard once that Tyler actually made it in like 10 minutes or something. Like, he wanted to make like a parody song of like New York rap or something, and then came up with this, which, you know, shot him to stardom straight up. Now, considering that this is his official debut album, we do have to be a little bit more forgiving, but I just really don't like this one. It doesn't even hold up to its predecessor mixtape, Bastard. But this one is still better than the Grinch EP. Now, this album is part of a so-called Wolf Trilogy, and what that means is that the first mixtape of Tyler, Bastard, and his first two albums, Goblin and Wolf, are tied together by one giant story talking about Tyler's mental delusions, basically. I'm not gonna get too deep into it, because there are many videos that can explain it much better than me. If you're interested, there's a video in the description. Notable songs from the record include Yonkers, Radicals, She, Trunket, and Analog. So at spot 6, I put the predecessor to Goblin, Bastard, Tyler's first mixtape. I like this one much more than Goblin. When I first listened to it, I basically enjoyed every song on it. This one is still a part of the Wolf Trilogy, and this time the mixing is acceptable. Especially on Pig's Fly, that sounds amazing. But there are some flaws here and there. Like the sound of Haji's verse on Slow It Down just doesn't sound right. We come through thriving, like thunderstorms, make the fees get wet and funky up in they underarms. I didn't know about this mixtape for far too long. I only really got into Tyler last December, when I was on a family trip to Debrecen, and I only found out about this mixtape at the very end of February. It amazes me that a 16 or 17 year old Tyler made all these songs. Bastard, 7, Odd Toddlers, Blow, Pig's Fly, VCR Wheels and Sarah are all such mind-blowingly amazing songs. And I don't know why, but the beats are not as annoying as on Goblin. They kinda sound like the more calm songs from Cherry Bomb. My favorite song from this record is probably Odd Toddlers, and I don't care that Tyler hates it, it's amazing. Acid, my accessorize accessories, bring out my assets, nigga, this sound on acid, tablets, Stussy G shock with my custom pair with 3D glass. It doesn't really have much to do with the story of the album, but there are many times when I skip 7 entirely just to listen to Odd Toddlers. This mixtape is so amazing, but, you know, Tyler's other records are just so strong that I had to put it at spot 6. Well, let's move on. At spot 5, I put the last part of the Wolf Trilogy, Wolf. I really wanted to put this behind Bastard, but it's just way too iconic for that. Now still, this album has some of the highest highs, but the lowest lows. This one will probably grow on me still, but I gotta say, I really don't care much for this record's deep cuts. I of course love Jamba, Rusty, Tamale, and the mid-album run from Awkward to I Fucking Hate You, but the songs I didn't mention I really don't have much care for. I pretty much always skip them. I have a weird feeling about this album, because it feels so wrong to put it this low, but it also feels right to put it under the ones above it. This is really the last album of Tyler's that sounds akin to Goblin and Bastard, and even though it doesn't sound terrible, its sound is kinda outdated still. It sucks that I had to put it this low because it contains some of my favorite Tyler, the Creator songs, but I put it lower on the list to make space for the two masterpieces. It's sad, but we have to move on. At spot 4 I put the first album that Tyler took really seriously, Flower Boy. The style of this record is unbelievable. I'm kinda sad that none of Tyler's other records sound like this. He kinda took the style of the softer side of Cherry Bomb and put like synths, strings and jazz elements to it. It's amazing. And also here the mixing is impeccable. The features on this album are also amazing. I mean, Rex Orange County, Frank Ocean, Kali Uchis, A$AP Rocky, Jaden Smith and Lil Wayne. This is really the first Tyler album where he talks openly about his sexuality, and it hits hard sometimes. Like the song See You Again, with an amazing vocal take from Kali and Tyler, Garden Shed and Glitter, they really like, they almost made me tear up sometimes, it's amazing. The only real problem I have with Flower Boy is that I can only listen to some of the songs on there if I'm in the right vibe. Most of the other songs on this list I can listen to at any time, but songs like Pothole, November and Enjoy Right Now Today get lost in the mix pretty easily for me. But don't get me wrong, these are all amazing, but I kinda can only listen to most of Flower Boy if I'm doing a full album listen, otherwise I almost never put them on. Also, the style of Flower Boy can get repetitive at times, so it's great that we have songs like Who That Boy and I Ain't Got Time that break up the style sometimes. This album has its own mood basically. Like, if you listen to the album and look at the cover at the same time, you'll feel like Flower Boy. I don't know how to explain it, but you definitely know what I mean. But how do I dare put Flower Boy at spot 4? Well, there's a record for me that beats Flower Boy by a lot, and it's probably Tyler's most divisive album so far. At spot 3 I put Cherry Bomb. As I said, this is probably Tyler's most divisive album, and it's probably the one that has grown on me the most. Like, when I first listened to it, I clicked on the title track and I was just like, no, no. But now, I love this album. Like, it's one of my favorite albums ever. Cherry Bomb is the first of Tyler's albums that doesn't follow a clear storyline. It's a transitional album between the early, angry and horrorcore Tyler and the Tyler that we got to know on his last three projects. It's angry and frustrated at times, but at other times it's quite calm, collected and emotional. We first got introduced to the signature sound of Cherry Bomb with the album opener Death Camp, which in my opinion works perfectly for the album opener. It's shifting between moods and distinct sections. It even has a little solo in it. And plus, I love the line, "Name my album Cherry Bomb because Grady Hit sounded boring." I only have one song that I don't like from Cherry Bomb, that being Run. I wouldn't have been too mad if it didn't get included, honestly. But all the other songs are great, or even perfect. Death Camp, Buffalo, Pilot, Find Your Wings, Blow Milo, Two Seater, Fucking Young, Smuckers, Keep Those, and Okaga are all perfect Tyler songs. All of the emotional songs on here have to be my top 20 favorite Tyler songs ever. All of them are so fucking amazing. But Run really brings down the quality of the album. I kinda have the same feeling with Cherry Bomb as I have with Amnesiac by Radiohead. An almost perfect album ruined by one or two awful songs. Looking at You, Pulk Pool and Life in a Glass House. It's difficult to choose a favorite song just because how high quality the album is. I mean, there's Smuckers, which features Lil Wayne and Kanye. There's Pilot, one of the best Tyler songs in every way possible. There's the absolutely beautiful, slow, emotional song Blow My Load. And by the way, I hate the fact that Tyler wrote one of his best beats and used it to write a song about fucking a girl. Amazing. There are 3 7-minute masterpieces on this album. Those being Two Seater, Fucking Young Perfect and Okaga California. Most people only have one real big problem with the album. The mixing. I'm going to admit it. It's bad. But it only really shines through in the title track and Run. Most of the other songs are like pretty tame compared to them. I put this album off for way too long as just, oh, bad mixing, terrible album, it fucking sucks. But that's really not true, it's an amazing record. Sure, it has problematic lyrics, but we have to like skate over that because basically every single Tyler, the Creator album has problematic lyrics. Like, I'm sorry, I didn't know you came here expecting The Wiggles or something. But still, some of his best songs are on here that again beat most of Flower Boy for me. At spot 2, I put the 2021 masterpiece, Call Me If You Get Lost. This one grew on me a lot too. When I first heard Corso, I obviously enjoyed it, but it didn't really blow my mind away. Also, DJ Drama's voice used to annoy me so fucking much that I didn't even listen to any songs from the record just because how pissed off I was. But now I think it adds a nice touch to the album. I think he like hypes up the songs really well. I think Call Me If You Get Lost is the best of the rappy Tyler albums, because sure, it might not be the best of them all, but from the rappy albums that Tyler released is the best. The record has a really like sitting in a deck chair beside my pool with a cold drink vibe. It's amazing. The choice of making many short and constantly looping songs was an amazing decision. It had so much replayability to the album. Like you put on Sir Baudelaire and you're just like, oh, just one more song. But then you just keep listening and listening. There are even 2 9-minute songs on this album, but they flow so well that you don't even notice it and they're already over. I truly can't choose a bad song from this album. Almost every track's perfect. There might be tracks that I enjoy a little less, but there are none that I straight up dislike. My favorite might be Hot Wind Blows, but I love every single one on here. I feel like Call Me If You Get Lost is the most like re-listenable Tyler album. I've been basically listening to Call Me If You Get Lost every day for like a month now. I'm not even half bored of it. It's unbelievable how perfect this album is. It fuses together every element that made Tyler great and just uses them in a way that still sounds refreshing and new. But then if Call Me If You Get Lost is so amazing, then why did I put it at spot number 2? Well, my favorite Tyler album is probably the favorite of many. At spot number 1 I put Igor. Yeah, this really shouldn't surprise you, I mean you kinda came here expecting me to put Igor at spot number 1. Oftentimes when doing album rankings, it's difficult to say stuff about the number 1 album, because there are just so many videos, comments, articles, pages and everything, that it's hard for me to say stuff that you didn't already hear 1,000 times, and it's the case here too. Igor is just so perfect and amazing and loved by so many people that I really can't say anything about it that hasn't been said like 1,000 times now. It has like no weak songs, no weak beats, no weak lyrics, everything about this album is perfect. It has an amazing story, an amazing selection of songs, which vary in style so much that basically anyone can find something they like on here. It was kinda like a bait for me to hook onto that made me start listening to hip hop music. Like it still feels rappy, but in its core it's a neo-soul R&B record with rap elements to it. That's why I think it's so accessible. It's without a doubt in my top 5 favorite albums ever. It's only beaten by Kid A by Radiohead and Revolver by The Beatles. It's impossible to choose a favorite song or even a favorite moment from the album, but if I was held at gunpoint, I'd choose New Magic Wand. And this is the only Tyler album, so far, that I have on CD. And for a good reason, I mean I haven't really found an album that makes me feel quite the same other than maybe like Mr. Morale and The Big Steppers by Kendrick. Now listen, just because I'm over here meat riding Tyler doesn't mean I don't listen to any other music, hip hop or not. So if you'd like me to rank other artists' albums, then feel free to leave a comment down below. And if you like this video, I'd really appreciate a like and a sub. I was Spelunky Monkey, and see you next time.